Hello and welcome to my art lesson. I can find inspiration for a piece of Impressionist artwork in the style of Monet. So in this lesson we would very much like you to go outside and snap some photos of nature. So you can be in your garden or on a walk with your family, anything like that. Or if you find something beautiful which inspires you, like a leaf or a twig or a stone, pick that up and bring it back home with you. And then when you have found your item or taken your photo, you can then follow Miss Brunt's How to Draw Like Monet guide here on the PowerPoint and create a beautiful picture. So what do we already know about Monet and the Impressionists? We know that they tried to capture the effects of light, that Impressionist artists mostly worked outside. They did not blend in the marks made by the paintbrush. They worked fast to capture the moment or to create an impression. They did not use black paint and they used contrasting colours. So pause the video and go and find your inspiration. Welcome back. So I went for a walk with my dogs and on the walk I took lots of pictures. This is the one that I have chosen to work from. So I chose this picture above all the other pictures because there's lots of contrasting colours, there's lots of play on light, there's nice negative space and positive space, and I felt it would just make an interesting picture. Once you have chosen your photo or your object, I'd like you to tell somebody why you have chosen that photo or that object. You could use the sentence, "I have chosen this image of leaves because I like the contrast of the colours of the green on the brown," or something along those lines. So to complete this task, you will need whatever art equipment you have at home. So I have raided my nephew's and niece's art drawer and I found a bumper drawing pack of paper, some crayons and some colouring pencils. I also found a pencil and I felt that that was all I needed. If you wanted to use paint, go for it, but remember, no black. The next part of the presentation is a video guide to completing your task. Don't forget, you can pause, rewind and re-watch any part at any time. So the first thing I did was to position the image in front of me so that I can see the picture as I was drawing it. I chose a spot which was quite prominent, in this case a nice dark green ivy leaf, and I just started to gently and lightly sketch it out. I then started to build up the rest of the picture behind that leaf, adding in the shapes that I could see. Because this is an impressionist piece of work, I did not want it to look perfect. I did not want it to look like the image that I was drawing my inspiration from. So I'm only giving the impression of the shapes of the leaves and the little twigs and mulch. So now I'm selecting the colours that I'm going to use. I've got some colouring pencils and some crayons, all in different shades of greens and browns. So I'm going to choose a dark brown and I'm going to start filling in some of the negative spaces. So that's the space behind the forefront pieces of information, so the leaves at the front basically. And I'm not using black. It would be tempting to use black because it's quite dark in the negative spaces. But I'm going to stick with my dark brown. Now I'm working quickly and using cross-hatching to get the image down as quickly as possible, because remember, ordinarily I would have done this outside like the Impressionist, but it's not a very nice day. It's a bit wet and windy and a bit cold, so I'm going to stay in my nice warm house and do it here. But I'm going to pretend that I am outside, so I'm going to work quite quickly. Now I'm using a lighter brown. I'm going to start working on some of these lighter brown leaves. Just again giving the impression of them. Always looking at the image that I'm drawing my inspiration from. So now I'm using a slightly thinner crayon because I can get some sharper lines in, a bit more definition. But I am still using those short, sharp strokes. If I was painting, I would be constantly lifting my brush up and down and doing really, really quick strokes. But we will look at that in a bit more detail in the coming weeks. So I've got an orange and a slightly greeny yellow. I'm just going to go back over those leaves again. If you look closely enough, you can usually see more than one colour in something. My greeny yellow. Really quick. Now I'm going to look at this ivy. Now this ivy has got the white veins in it, as you can see. But I've drawn my veins a little bit too thick, so I am going to make them a bit thinner. And I will use a colouring pencil. So the white bits on the leaf I'm going to leave white by not colouring them in. And now I'm going to focus on this leaf, the first leaf that I drew. I'm going to use a dark brown again, because there are some darker veins and some darker shades on that leaf. And this will be at like a undercoat, I guess, for the colour. Go over it in green. Nice short sharp movement. Dark green again. A bit more depth to that leaf. Add a little bit more detail onto that one, make it ping and pop. So you can see that the orange and the green are contrasting colours. So the orange is helping to make the green really stand out on the picture. I think I'm nearly done. I think I'm quite happy with that so far. Just a really quick, really simple impression. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video and you produced some beautiful pieces of artwork. Mrs. Podro and I cannot wait to see what you have done. Just a quick recap on today's lesson. So today we have recalled the key points of Impressionism, explored nature to find some inspiration, said why we have chosen our inspiration, and learnt how to do a drawing in the Impressionist style. Now have a quick go at the quiz to see how much you have learnt, and well done everybody.